So I was sitting in the hotel room and I was programming computers in the internet, and then I decided to just go. I'm a huge fan of the Flaming Lips, and I just decided to go drive over to Wayne Coyne's house. Just no reason. And go past the front of it, maybe take a picture, maybe take a selfie, maybe shoot a video. So this is sort of what happened. Well, I'm not gonna lie, this is the weirdest fucking thing I've ever done. But I'm standing in front of the compound of Wayne Coyne, the lead singer of the Flaming Lips, and I've been a fan of theirs since Here It Is, and back in, God, it must have been like 85. I was in high school, and they came out with that EP, and then they came out with Oh My God, the Flaming Lips, and just great stuff, and then they've just continued to be awesome over the years, and I'm just a huge fan, and here I am, randomly passing through Oklahoma City, and decided to just do this weirdest fucking thing I've ever done, and I hope he's not looking out his window right now. Anyway, huge, huge fan. This almost feels religious, I'll be honest. Okay, that's it. I'm dumb. Bye. Okay, so not what I expected. I'm standing like a fool in front of Wayne Coyne's house, shooting a video. Then I decide to drive around the block and maybe shoot something from another angle. Then all of a sudden, who's this? It's Wayne and his wife walking down the street with their kid. And I drive by slowly and I wave, and then he kind of comes over to the car and I get out and I talk to the dude, and he's like the nicest guy in the world, thankfully. I mean, he lives in this neighborhood, and that says a lot. I mean, this is just like a regular neighborhood in Oklahoma City, and I think it's really fucking awesome. Wow. So then he's like, yeah, let's take selfies. I don't do that. I've never really done that with people. Like, I've never asked for a selfie from anybody, like, quote-unquote famous. But, dude, this is a guy that I've listened to, like I said earlier, for my whole life. I mean, basically since I really started loving music, and I was a huge fan of their early stuff, and just listened to them throughout the years. When I worked at MTV, I kind of secretly hoped that they would come in for an event when I worked at MTV Online, but they didn't. And then, you know, I've been to shows, and now got to meet the dude, which I'm really happy about. Well, I made my day. I'm going to go back and program in the hotel. That's what I'm doing next. So I don't know why I'm shooting this, but here I am. Okay, later. Peace. And so that's it. I normally am not a fanboy. I normally don't act shaky and strange and whatever. But music is super important to me. I remember when I first met the Ween guys and Mickey. It was different because I had already talked to Mickey on the phone a bunch, helped him learn HTML, and it's like in the 90s. And so by the time I met him in person, I had a relationship with him already, so it was different. But I'm a huge Ween fan too, and you know, that was like a big deal. But you know, this is a guy that like I've listened to this band, as I've said like three times, since I was a kid, like since I was just really getting into music and really figuring out what I liked. And I liked their early stuff. I liked a lot of stuff along the way. The Soft Bulletin is obviously like an amazing record. Steven had a lot to do with that one. And, you know, they've just been in a groove. I like their experimental stuff, you know, everything. And so just to roll up and just come across this person on the street was just weird and took me out of my element. And I was like shaky and strange. And I mean, I've met people, you know, that I met Ray Weiss, you know, who I was a huge fan of Twin Peaks, and I worked on a movie with him, and I was not like this. I was just like, hey man, nice to meet you. But for some reason, music really is different. And anyway, I'm rambling on, but I just wanted to share this for no reason. So here it is. Here it is. That's funny. Bye.